Hello friends, welcome to our channel Aha Jindagi. In the last lecture of geometric progressions, we have seen what is geometric progression, how to find nth term of a geometric progression, and selection of terms in a geometric progression. So today we will discuss some of terms of a GP, properties of geometric progression, and a sum of infinite GP, and we will see insertion of terms in a GP or geometric mean, we can say. So those who have not seen our last lecture, please see the description box and find our link for the lecture one so that you can easily understand this lecture. Okay friends, so today we will see how to sum the terms of a GP. So we will start from here. Sum of the terms of a GP, of a geometric progression. So sum is given by Sn equal to A into R to the power n minus 1 divided by R minus 1, or in, we can write this also A into 1 minus R to the power n divided by 1 minus R. Here R is not equal to 1. See, if R equal to 1, our denominator will become 0. Okay, so suppose our series is, or we can say let Sn denote the sum. How to prove this? Okay, if Sn is the sum of a GP, say A plus AR plus AR square plus ARn minus 2, and nth term will be ARn minus 1. So consider it as equation 1. Can we write Sn also as on, okay, we will multiply Sn by R. So R of Sn, we can write AR plus AR square plus AR cube. Similarly, this term will become ARn minus 1 plus ARn. This is our equation 2. So subtracting 2 from 1, or on subtracting, on subtracting 2 from 1, what we will get? Sn minus Rsn, or we can write Sn into 1 minus R equal to, if we subtract here, you see this minus, minus, minus. Okay, all this will become minus. So see, this term will be cancelled by this. AR square will get cancelled. Similarly, AR cube will get cancelled. ARn minus 1, this will get cancelled. This will also get cancelled with previous term from here. So we have A minus AR to the power n. So can we find Sn from here? See, Sn equal to, take A as common, 1 minus R to the power n by 1 minus R. Okay. So this is what we need to prove. Sometimes normal practice is what is followed when R is less than 1, then Sn will be given by A into 1 minus r to the power n by 1 minus r. When r is greater than 1, Sn is given by A into r to the power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. See, both will give same result. However, it is followed like this in many books. So we may follow and make our practice to follow this. Okay, friends. So remember these two formula. We will solve some problem. Okay, consider our, if L is the last term, if L equal to ARN minus 1, L is our last term. Can we write Sn equal to A minus AR to the power N divided by 1 minus R? Or we can write A minus ARN minus 1 into R divided by 1 minus R. So we can write it as A minus ARN minus 1 is our, this term is L. So A minus LR by 1 minus R, or this can also be written as LR minus A by R minus 1. Okay, friends. So now, based on the formula of sum of terms of a GP, we will see few problems related to this. Let's clear this. So a question is, consider this question. Sum the series. What is the series? C, x into x plus y plus x square into x square plus y square plus x cube into x to the power 3 plus y to the power 3 plus up to n terms, 2n terms, okay? 2n terms. So how to sum this? Let Sn denote the sum of the series. So Sn we can write as, if we multiply this, what we will get? X square plus y square plus x to the power 4 plus y to the power 4. Sorry. This we can write as Sn equal to x square plus xy plus x to the power 4 plus x square y square plus x to the power 6 plus x cube into y cube. 2n terms. So we take x square, x 4, x 6. These terms we take as x square plus x to the power 4 plus x to the power 6. It will be for n term, nth term, it will be x to the power 2n. Similarly, if we take this xy, so we can write this as xy plus xy whole square plus xy whole cube up to n terms, so the nth term will be xy to the power n. So now we have two GP, we can sum it as separately. So this will become, what is the formula? A into, so for this A is x square into r to the power n minus 1. Here r is x to the power 4 by x square. So it is x square So r to the power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. So x square minus 1. For this series, we have a, that is first term is xy into xy to the power r is xy whole square divided by xy. So xy to the power n minus 1 divided by xy minus 1. Okay, friends. So this is our solution Sn equal to x square, or we can write this as Sn equal to x square into x to the power 2n minus 1 divided by x square minus 1 plus xy into xy to the power n minus 1 divided by xy minus 1. So this is our sum of the given series. Another problem we can see, consider a problem like, first let us clear this. See, we have been given Sn. We have to find Sn. What is Sn? 5 plus 55, 5 plus 55 plus 5, up to 2n terms. We have to add this. Okay, we have to find Sn. So can we write this as, we will take 5 as common. So our series will be 1 plus 11 plus 555 by 5. It is 111. Up to enter. Then what we need to do? We will divide by 9. We will see this is not in GP. Okay. So we first divide it by 9. And multiply here by 9 to all terms. So it will become 9 plus 999 here. Okay. 2n terms. 2n terms. Then what we can do? We will write 9 as 10 minus 1. Similarly, we can write 99 as 10 square minus 1. 999 as 10 cube minus 1. Similarly, it will repeat up to n terms. Now, if you see, we will get two series, 5 by 9. So 10, 10 square, 10 cube, this will be in GP. So 10 plus 10 square plus 10 cube up to n terms, or we can write 10 to the power n. Similarly, here we will get another series of 1, 1 up to n terms. So 1 plus 1 plus 1, 2 n terms. Now, if you see this, we can write this, what is the sum of this GP? So A into R is our 10. So 10 to the power N minus 1 divided by 10 minus 1. Minus, if we add 1 N number of times, we will get as N. Okay, friends. Now we will get 5 by 9. Here it is 10 by 9 into 10 to the power n minus 1 minus n. So we will take this as LCM and take 9 as common. So 5 by 81. So 10 into 10 to the power n. So 10 to the power n plus 1 minus 10 minus this 9 into n. So 9n. So this is our Sn. Similarly, if you see, we can find sum of terms like 0.7 plus 0.77 plus 0.777. All this series we can find like this. What here we will do? We have to take 7 as common. Then we will get 1 by 10 plus, or we can take 7 as common. So 1 by 10 plus 7 or 11 by 100 plus 111 by 1000. Then we have to multiply by 9 and divide it by 9. Then we will get numerator as 1 minus 1 by 10. Okay, just I will show you. See, if we take, suppose this is S. We take 7 as common, so it will become 1 by 10 plus 11 by 100 plus 111 by 1000. So like this up to n terms. Next, what we have to do, we have to divide here by 9 and multiply each term by 9. 99 by 100 plus 999 by 1000. Okay, this we can write as 7 by 9 into 10 minus 1 by 10 plus 100 minus 1 by 100 plus 1000 minus 1 by 1000. And we have to repeat up to n terms. Okay, so now we will get two series. One as 1 here, see, if we divide it by 10, we will get 7 by 9 into 1 minus 1 by 10. Similarly, we will get 1 minus 1 by 100. So we will get two series. First series, each term will be 1 n times. Second, we will get 1 by 10 as first term and common ratio as 1 by 100 divided by 1 by 10. So common ratio will be 1 by 10. So we will get two series and we can add using a formula of sum of a GP. Okay, friends. So next we will solve, we will see sum of an infinite GP. Sum of an infinite GP. Sum of an infinite geometric progression. So how to do this? See, sum is given by S equal to A by 1 minus R. If R is less than 1, okay, mod R is less than 1, or we can write R is greater than minus 1 and less than 1. Okay, so our series is, see, if S equal to 1 or we can write as A plus AR plus AR square plus AR cube up to infinite terms, so AR to the power infinity. Here n tends to infinity, or we can write AR n, and n tends to infinity. So S is given by, as per our formula, Sn equal to A into 1 minus r to the power n divided by 1 minus r, n tends to infinity. So you see, if r is less than 1 and n tends to infinity, so if we take any item which is less than 1 and raise that to the power infinity, it will become 0. We can see from here, if we take 1 by 10, you write 1 by 10 to the power 100 or 1000, it will become 1 by 10 to the power 1000. So it will be similar to 0. Similarly here, if r is less than 1, we will get a into 1 minus 0 by 1 minus r. So a by 1 minus r is our sum of an infinite GP. Only condition is mod of r is less than 1. So we will solve one question related to this. Consider a question 6 to the power 1 by 2 into 6 to the power 1 by 4 into 6 to the power 1 by 8 into up to infinite number of terms. Okay, we have to find this. So what we have to do, can we write this as 6 to the power, all are multiples, so we can write in the power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 up to infinite. So what we can do, this is an infinite geometric progression with first term 1 by 2 and common ratio also 1 by 2. So we can write 6 to the power a is 1 by 2 by 1 minus 1 by 2. What we will get, 6 to the power 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2. So it will cancel out. We will get 6 to the power 1 of 6. So this is how we have to prove this. Now we will see the properties of geometric progression. Okay, what are the properties of geometric progression? Properties of geometric progression. First property is, if all the terms of a GP, if all the terms of a GP is multiplied or divided by the same non-zero constant, by the same non-zero constant, then it remains a GP. A GP with same common ratio. With same common ratio. Okay. So consider this. If AR square AR cube, this is a GP. Okay. If we multiply or divide by a constant, let's say we multiply this by k. So the resulting series will be k a1 k a r 1 k a r k a r square k a r cube. So if we find a2 by a1, we will get a2 by a1, we will get k a r by k a, so it still remains r. a3 by a2, this is a2 by a1, a3 by a2 equal to k a r square divided by k a r, it is again r. So if we multiply or divide all the terms by a non-zero constant k or any constant, then the resulting series is also in GP with same common ratio. See the another property. Second property is the reciprocals of the terms of a given GP form a GP. So if a1, a2, a3 be a GP with common ratio R, let a1, a2, a3 is a GP, common ratio is equal to R. If we take the reciprocal of this, then resulting series will be 1 by a1, 1 by a2, 1 by a3. So in this, what is the common ratio? So we have to find a2, common ratio is 1 by a2 divided by 1 by a1, or we can write 1 by a1 into r divided by 1 by a1 or 1 by r, we will get 1 by r. So our common ratio will change to 1 by r. So new common ratio, is equal to 1 by r. So let's clear it. Third property you will see. Our third property is, if each term of a GP be raised to the same power, the resulting sequence also forms a GP. The resulting sequence also forms a GP. So see this. If a1, a2, a3 up to n terms is in GP with common ratio equal to R. If we raise each term of a GP, of the given GP, to the same power, we will get a1 to the power k, you say, a2 to the power k, a3 to the power k, up to n terms. So in this, if we find new a2, or we can say capital A2 by a1 equal to a2 to the power k divided by a1 to the power k, or we can write a2 by a1 to the power k. This is what r to the power k. Similarly, a3 by a2 equal to a3 by a2 equal to a3 to the power k divided by a2 to the power k, or a3 by a2 to the power k equal to r to the power k. So we can see common ratio is still same for all the terms when it is divided by the preceding terms. So we can say the resulting series is also will also be a GP with common ratio r to the power k. Okay, so common ratio power will also be raised by the power. Next property we will see, fourth. So fourth property is, if in a finite GP the product of term equidistant from the beginning and the end is always same and is equal to the product of first and the last term in a finite GP. Product of the terms equidistant from the beginning and the end is always same and is equal to first and last term, to product of first and last term. Okay, so consider a GP, let a1, a2, a3 up to an be a GP with common ratio r. So if we take kth term from the beginning, equal to a1 into r to the power k minus 1. Similarly, if we take kth term from the end, we can write kth term from the end will be n minus k plus 1th term from beginning. And it will be a1 into r to the power n minus k. Okay, this we have seen in the last lecture, how to calculate kth term from the end. Okay, now if we take product of kth term from the beginning and kth term from the end, so kth term from beginning into kth term from end, equal to what we will get, see, a1 into r to the power k minus 1 into a1 into r to the power n minus k. So we will get a1 into a1 to the power r. See, this is k minus 1 plus n minus k. So n minus k plus k minus 1. K will cancel out. and we will get a1 into a1 to the power a1 into r to the power n minus 1. So we will get a1 into an. So a1 is the first term and an is the last term. So this is how we can prove. We will see the next property. Let's clean the board. Property 5th of GP, 3 non-zero numbers A, B, C are in GP. 3 non-zero numbers are numbers. What are the numbers? A, B, C are in GP. If and only if B square equal to AC. See how we can prove this. If ABC are in GP, ABC are in GP, then we will get B by A common ratio equal to C by B. Okay. If and only if B square equal to AC. This is what we need to prove. Next property we'll see. If the terms of a given GP are chosen at regular intervals. At regular intervals, then the new sequence formed also forms a GP. Then the new sequence so formed. Also forms a GP. Okay. See if A1 or AR square, AR cube, AR4, AR5, AR6. This is in GP. Okay. If we take terms at regular intervals, like if we take suppose alternate terms we are considering A, AR square, AR4, AR6. So our new sequence will be A, AR square, AR4, AR6. Only odd terms we are considering. So if we see this series, here also first term is A. And ratio of a term with its preceding term is r square. So common ratio will be ar square by a or ar to the power 4 by ar square. It is same as r square. Okay. Next we can see if a1, a2, a3, an is a GP, of non-zero, non-negative and non-zero terms, then log of a1, log of a2, log of an is an AP and vice versa. So how to prove this? See, we have to consider non-zero and non-negative. It is because log in is only defined when a1, a2, an is greater than 0. Okay. So we can write, since A1, A2, A3 are in GP, so An equal to A1 into R to the power n minus 1. Taking log both sides, we can write log of An equal to log of A1 plus n minus 1 into log of R. Okay, log of An, if we take log of An as Bn, so Bn equal to log An, Bn equal to log of An equal to log of A1 plus n minus 1 log R. Okay. So next we will calculate Bn plus 1 minus Bn. We will get log of A1 plus n plus 1 minus 1, n plus 1 minus 1 into log R minus Bn is our log of A1 minus, or here we will use bracket, plus n minus 1 log R. See, this term will cancel out from this term and we will get n minus 1, n minus 1, so we will get log of R, okay, which is equal to constant, since R is constant, okay. So if A1, A2, A3 are in GP, log A1, A2, log A3 are is in AP. Similarly, we can prove if log A1, A2 and log An is in AP, then A1, A2, A3 up to An, that series will be in GP. Okay. Now we will see some problems related to properties. Let's clean this. Okay, so suppose A, B, C, our question is A, B, C, D are in GP. Then we have to prove that A to the power n plus B to the power n, B to the power n plus C to the power n, similarly C to the power n plus D to the power n, are also in geometric progression. So how to proceed here? So let's say R be the common ratio of the GP. Let common ratio equal to R for GP A, B, C, D. So we will get V equal to AR, C equal to AR square and D equal to AR cube. Okay. Now we will calculate A to the power N plus B to the power N, which is equal to A to the power N plus B equal to AR to the power n, or if we take a to the power n common, so 1 plus r to the power n. Similarly, we can calculate b to the power n plus c to the power n. So it is b to the power n is ar to the power n plus c is ar square to the power n. If we take a to the power n into r to the power n common, we will get 1 plus r to the power n. Next, we will calculate c to the power n plus d to the power n equal to ar square to the power n plus ar cube to the power n. So this we will get a to the power n into r to the power 2n to 1 plus r to the power n. Okay. Now, if we take second term square, b to the power n plus c to the power n whole square, it is equal to a to the power 2n, or we can proceed in another way. If we can prove, if this is your second term b, a and c, okay, if we are able to prove b square equal to ac, we can say that these terms will be in GP. So we will do a into c. So what is ac? A to the power n into 1 plus r to the power n into c is a to the power n into r to the power 2n into 1 plus r to the power n. Okay. So we can see from here, it is a to the power n plus n, so a to the power 2n into r to the power 2n into 1 plus r to the power n whole square. Or we can say a to the power n into r to the power n 1 plus r to the power n whole square equal to b square. Therefore, b square equal to ac. Since b square equal to ac, so these terms a to the power n plus b to the power n, b to the power n plus c to the power n, and c to the power n plus d to the power n are in GP. Okay, friends. So we have seen this. Next, in this, one term is remaining, geometric progression, geometric means. So we will see what are geometric means and how to insert geometric means between two given numbers. So insertion of geometric means between two given numbers, okay, friends. So what are geometric means? Geometric means we denote by GM. Let A and B be two given numbers, and if n numbers G1, G2 up to Gn are inserted between A and B such that A, G1, G2, Gn and B is a GP, then the numbers G1, G2, Gn are known as n geometric means. So here, if A and B are two numbers which is given, and we insert n geometric means G1, G2, G3, Gn and B, if this sequence is in GP, then G1, G2, G3 up to Gn are n geometric means. Now we can see B is equal to C. There are n geometric means and A and B are two more terms. So total number of terms will be n plus 2. And our last term B will be n plus 2s term. N plus 2s term. Okay. So B equal to, if we assume R is the common ratio, common ratio equal to R. So B equal to A into R to the power n plus 2 minus 1, or we can say A R to the power n plus 1. So from here we will get R equal R to the power n plus 1 equal to B by A, or R equal to B by A to the power n 1 by n plus 1. So this is the common ratio of the resulting series. So we can easily now find G1. G1 will be A into R. G2 equal to AR square. G3 equal to AR cube. Similarly, Gn will be equal to AR to the power n. Okay. So this is how we find geometric means. If only one geometric mean has to be inserted, see, if A, G and B, if only G is the single mean to be inserted between A and B, then we will have G square equal to AB. Okay. So this is how. One more thing we can see. See, if A is the arithmetic mean, A is equal to arithmetic mean, and G equal to geometric mean, so we have between two numbers, between A and B. Okay. So A equal to A plus B by 2 and G equal to under root AB. So can we find A minus G? If A minus G we find, so A plus B by 2 minus under root AB. Or we can write it as A plus B minus 2 under root AB by 2, or this is equal to half of under root A minus under root B whole square, and this is always greater than 0 if A is not equal to B. Okay friends, so we will see a problem based on geometric means. Let's clear this. So one question we will see based on this. One question. Insert five geometric means. Insert five geometric means between 576 between 576 and 9. So we have to find five geometric means. Here we have A equal to 576 first term, and B is the last term. 576 B is the last term. B equal to 9. If G1, G2, G5 are 5 means, 5 are 5 geometric means, we can calculate R as b by a to the power 1 by n plus 1 by n plus 1. So here what will be our n? N is 5 geometric mean. So b is 9 divided by 576 to the power n 1 by 5 plus 1. Please don't confuse this n with number of total terms in the GP. It is number of means. Okay. So 9 by 576 will be equal to 1 by 64 to the power 1 by 6, which is equal to 1 by 2. So we have R equal to 1 by 2, A equal to 576. So can we calculate G1, G2, G3? G1 will be A into R, which is equal to 576 into 1 by 2. Equal to 288. Similarly, G2 equal to AR square, it will be equal to 144. G3 equal to AR cube, it is equal to 72. G4 equal to AR4 will be equal to 36. And G5 will be equal to AR to the power 5, it is equal to 80. So this is how we can solve this. Okay friends. So today we have completed this whole chapter. We have seen what is a GP, how to calculate nth term, how to calculate the sum of a geometric progression, how to sum an infinite geometric series when R is less than 1. We have seen the properties of a geometric progression and how to calculate the n geometric means between two given numbers. So friends, if you have seen the whole video and you have any doubt, please let us know your doubts and please write your doubts in our comment box so that we will reply to your doubts. And if you have seen all the whole video and you liked our video, please like the video and subscribe our channel Aha Jindagi. And please press the bell icon button so that you will get notification when our next video will be uploaded. Okay friends, thank you.